Hello friends, today I am Dr. Rajni Gaur going to take up two new topics from the subject language across the curriculum. My topic are emergent literacy, meaning, definition, concept of emergent literacy before and now, and components of emergent literacy. The second topic is developing effective presentation by integration of four language skills effectively. Under it, we will going to discuss principles of developing effective presentation and procedure of developing effective presentation. Before going to the topic emergent literacy, very first we would like to discuss what is literacy. There are many skills that are necessary to function in today's world. One such key skill in our society is literacy, which can be thought of as the ability to read and write. Think about it. How far could you get in life without being able to read? You would not even be able to find correct street signs as you walk down the street. Now, the meaning of emergent literacy and its definition. Emergent literacy is the idea that learning literacy actually begins at very early age, long before official lesson in school. This term is used to describe the knowledge a child has of reading and writing before reaching the age where those skills are taught. Emergent literacy argues that right after birth, children are already in the process of becoming literate. Now, the definition of emergent literacy. Mary Clay in 1996 gave the definition of emergent literacy. She was the first person who used the term emergent literacy. According to her, emergent literacy is based on an assumption that a child acquires some knowledge about language, reading and writing, even before attending any formal education. She asserted that literacy development begins early in life and is ongoing. Now, the concept of emergent literacy before and now. It means here, we just want to discuss the concept of emergent literacy when it was not introduced and after the introduction of this concept. Before, early literacy was somewhat neglected, but nowadays there is a great deal of attention to literacy development in early childhood. Little attention given to a child's literacy was in grade 1. Acquisition of given information about literacy begins at birth and continues at the course of early childhood. Assumed that the beginning of literacy was in grade 1, but development of literacy in a child's earliest years. Before the concept of emergent literacy, speaking and listening were learned in early childhood, while reading and writing were learned in school age. Whereas in case of emergent literacy nowadays, simultaneous development of language related abilities takes place. Reading instructions was ignored in preschool education, but emphasis on oral language development and preparation for reading is focused now. No advocacy for formal reading instructions in early childhood. whereas nowadays capitalized on child's existing knowledge, information about literacy and reading and writing experiences. Before, preschoolers were not perceived as readers and writers, but now children are active constructors of their own learning, waiting for a child's natural maturation to unfold, but nurture through emergent literacy from birth to kindergarten to grade 1. Preparation for literacy was through the acquisition of a set of prescribed hierarchy of skills. But now, continuous building of knowledge on oral language, reading and writing. Progression from part to whole, which it is the concept which is given by a very famous psychologist, and he said that a set of skills is prerequisite to reading. Children learn from meaningful and functional situations. Drills from concrete and writing had been certainly missing, and writing develops after reading. But nowadays children are interested and attempt early to communicate in writing, reading and writing are cultivated concurrently. After discussing the concept of emergent literacy before and now, we can conclude that emergent literacy is a term that is used to explain child's knowledge of reading and writing skills before they learn how to read and write words. It signals a belief that in literate society, young children, even 1 and 2 year olds, are in the process of becoming literate. Through the support of parents, caregivers, and educators, a child can successfully progress from emergent to conventional reading. Now, there are certain characteristics of emergent literacy, and what they are? So the very first is, the key factor that support emergent literacy include how some children come into their school years already familiar with the reading and writing process. These children do not know how to combine letters to make words, but they do know some important things about literacy. For example, most children learn from the modeling of parents reading to them at bedtime. Usually, children easily notice their mom or dad read their bedtime stories from left to right. Later on, when learning to read in school, the child already knows to start at the left of the page first. Secondly, emergent literacy involves learning basic phonemic awareness. Now, what are the phonemes? The phonemes are unit of sound. For instance, FR is a phoneme and which has a sound fr. It is the first unit of sound in words like friend, frame and freeze. Now, the emergent literacy has some basic components which are very essential to develop emergent literacy skills. So what these components are? There are 6 components, and the very first component is print motivation. It is the first step of emergent literacy. Through this step, children become interested in print materials, because this step occurs before the child can actually read or write. The child's interest is seen through the enjoyment of being read to and playing with books and pretending to read or write. You must have found many children, those who are not in the formal school system, but still they are very keen to observe the images into the magazines, newspapers and books, or the colorful images attract them and they pretend like they are reading, but they kept the book sometime in the opposite direction or in the wrong direction, but still it attracts them. Second is the vocabulary. Vocabulary development is a significant predictor to a child's overall academic achievement. Vocabulary can be measured or seen as a child's ability to know the name of things. And we know that vocabulary is enhanced in the students while interacting with various persons in their environment. Third is print awareness. It is the step in which children learn how to handle a book and begin to recognize the differences between letters and words. During this step, children also learn how texts are organized, realizing that reading is completed from left to right and from the top of the page to the bottom of the page. Next one is narrative skills. It is the literacy step when children develop the ability to tell a story or describe a sequence of events. Next is letter awareness. It occurs when children understand that letters are unique from each other and begin to recognize different letters and their sound. They can easily make a distinction between the letters. Phonological awareness. It is the process by which children begin to understand that words are made up of different sounds or phonemes, and that is stringing these sounds together create words and results in meaning. They know that if we associate these alphabets together, what kind of sounds they produce and how to produce that word. He knows that to arrange the alphabet in haphazard manner cannot help them out to produce or to create a word. So I have completed with the first topic, and I start with the second topic, that is developing effective presentation by the integration of four language skills, principles and procedures. Dear friends, if we want to make a presentation, we first need to follow certain principles which are very essential while making the presentation by integrating the four language skills. And the four basic language skills are reading, writing, listening, speaking. So what are those principles which we have to follow? So before that, I just want to tell you that what is presentation? The term presentation refers to an act of presenting something to someone for the purpose of communication. It is a way to put out ideas, views, thoughts, feelings about an object, event, or a person in an effective manner. It enhances the effectiveness of content and teaching as they are well organized. For the development of presentation, following principles should be considered. So let's see what these principles are which we have to keep in our mind while making the presentations. First principle is principle of child-centeredness. The word is self-explanatory, child-centeredness, something which is to be designed by keeping in mind that what are the needs and desires of the child. This principle says that presentation should be according to the learner, not for the teacher. Presentation should be prepared with the comprehension of the people. Whatever the content we are designing in the form of presentation, that should be according to the need of the child. Principle of interest. Topic for the presentation should be selected as per the interest of learners. The presentations should be made interesting so that the learner may get pleasure rather than feel bored. So we need to follow the rule of versatility while making the presentations. Third principle is principle of utility. This principle says that we only take interest which is useful for us. So whatever the content we want to deliver through the presentation, that needs to be useful for the student, that only the students will take the interest. So topic and content should be selected which is related to the day-to-day life of the learners. Presentation should be based on their life experiences. Then they'll take interest into it. Next is principle of motivation. teacher should motivate their students as it is the heart of learning and has the power to influence their performance in all spheres of life. Motivation works wonder in the classroom. If we motivate our students, we appreciate them, definitely students will come up with their potential and improve their performance. Next is principle of making use of maximum senses. Educationists rightly said that senses are the doors of learning. So it is very essential that while making the presentation, we need to prepare our presentation in such a manner so it will help the students to use their senses, and they will keep that content with them for a longer period of time. The presentation should be in such a way which involves maximum senses of learners, and the use of maximum senses by learner help him in getting the knowledge. Principle of cooperation. As students are at initial stage unable to make their presentations very effective, so at this stage they seek cooperation from their teacher. And that is the foremost responsibility of the teacher to help her students in the best possible ways. But do not follow spoon feeding. She needs to help them out like a guide and ask them to do it by themselves. At initial stage, cooperation is required from a teacher. Teacher should cooperate learners in preparation and presentation, as it will help the learners in boosting up their morals. Principles of simple to complex. Presentation should follow the maxims of teaching so that the task should be presented in front of them in a simple manner and gradually enhance the difficulty level of content. Principle of reinforcement. Reinforcement plays a vital role in learning, so that it is essentially required to give reinforcement to the learner for their better learning. Reinforcement should be provided by the teacher in very appropriate or equal proportion or proportionate to their performance. So the students will not become overconfident. But yes, appropriate reinforcement help them in bringing their confidence level up and to perform better in the classroom. Principle of individual attention. Every child needs the attention of their teacher. But if teacher do not give attention to all the students in equal manner, then it definitely influence, or we can say that not influence, but definitely it affects the child. This principle is based on the fact that every child is important and each child is a teacher should give attention to needs and desires of every students. So no one feels neglected in the class. Principle of correct attitude. Dear friends, we all know that attitude can be positive and can be negative, but whatever kind of attitude we carry with us during an event or during learning, that definitely affects our learning. If we are having positive attitude, our learning is fruitful. But if we are having negative attitude, definitely it hampers our learning. So attitude is important in every walks of life. And a learner shows negative attitude about others, a teacher should try to make his attitude positive. Now, we move to the procedure of developing presentation. Dear friends, we all know that presentation should be presented in front of the audience, and if it is proper and prepared nicely, then only it leaves an impact on the audience. So while developing presentation, we need to follow certain steps. And what these steps are? The first step is planning. And we all know that if we plan something beforehand, there is a very less chance of error, and it also boosts our confidence. So planning is an important stage of any process or procedure. It guides us and shows us direction in which we have to work upon. It not only prevents waste but also helps the teacher and students to be systematic and orderly. It helps in proper organization of work and to draws our attention to the goals. And with the help of the planning, teacher will be able to fulfill the objectives she has in her mind before presenting the content. This first step has some sub-steps, and out of those sub-steps, the first one is selection of the language skill. Before developing presentation, one should decide which skill among the four skills of language one should focus. It means whether one should focus on reading, writing, listening or speaking. The selection of a skill depends on various things like level of students, objectives of the syllabus, interest of learners, etc. Oral presentations prove more effective in early stages. Two or more language skills may be integrated into a presentation. Our second sub-step is selection of a skill. After selection of linguistic skill, presentation skill should be selected, which is again depend on mental age, objectives, interest of the learner, and on the language skill selected earlier. A learner may select among poem recitation, role play, drama, or debate, etc. for their presentation or the content they have chosen. Now, our second step is making a draft. A draft of presentation should be prepared keeping objectives in mind. Third step is making a final draft. After editing in the previous draft, final draft should be prepared, and teacher needs to help the students in editing if it is required. And the final touch should be given to the presentation according to the planning. Our next step is tryout. Before the final presentation, a student should try out his own presentation, as the practice will help him in boosting self-confidence. And if the child is having any problem or he is committing any mistake, that can be modified or rectified during this step. Our next step is presentation, and this is the final stage or the final step when finished material is presented in a classroom by learners. After completing the presentation, proper feedback should be provided by the teacher and the peer members, and that feedback helps the child to improve his or her future presentations. Examples of presentations are poetry recitation, declamation, dramatization, role play, summarizing, comprehension, etc. And out of these, anyone can be selected by the learner for his or her presentation according to the content the child is presenting. Thank you. Hope this presentation helps you to understand these two topics clearly. Thank you so much.